Yeah, welcome back. So I was telling about the chelator, and already in your first class you also studied that about sequestering agent means it is the ligand which forms a stable and water soluble metal chelate, or it forms a stable water soluble cyclic complex. Forms a stable water-soluble cyclic complex, and such a ligand we call it as a sequestering agent. And examples for sequestering agents are citric acid, tartaric acid, EDTA, etc. Citrates, tartrates, EDTA, etc. These are the examples of sequestering agent. Okay. So that is about the basic concepts of chelate and the chelate type of complexes. Now here, this is actually my favorite question in your viva. Usually I used to ask this in viva. That is, here chlorophyll and hemoglobin, these are the naturally occurring chelates. The naturally occurring chelates are chlorophyll and hemoglobin. Yeah. Chlorophyll and hemoglobin are the naturally occurring chelates. Chlorophyll that you find in plants. Now, after that, let us study about few applications of chelates. That is, chelates find applications in pharmacy. See, sometimes what happens, for 5 marks, they may ask you to just write about chelate type of complexes. Or for 10 marks, they may ask you to explain about metal ion complexes or metal complexes. If they ask you for 10 marks for metal complexes, you have to write all the four. That is inorganic type, chelate, olefins, and aromatic type. If they ask you only for 5 marks for chelate, you have to write A to Z about chelate along with its applications. So its very first application is increase in stability. So formation of chelates will increase the stability of a drug or a compound. That is, usually ascorbic acid has a tendency to undergo oxidative degradation. That is, whenever ascorbic acid is exposed to the oxygen, it undergoes oxidative degradation or decomposition in fruit juices. Oxidative degradation of ascorbic acid in fruit juices and in drug preparations, it can be avoided by the addition of chelating agents such as EDTA. So what will happen? This EDTA will form a cyclic complex, and this ascorbic acid will form the central ion. The central ion surrounded by this EDTA. In that way, you can prevent the oxidative degradation of ascorbic acid. And not only that, the metal ions such as iron and copper, which are present in the solutions, will accelerate the degradation of ascorbic acid. So what these metal ions will be treated? So these metal ions will be chelated with EDTA so that the metal ions will not have a chance to accelerate the degradation of this ascorbic acid, and ascorbic acid is prevented. I'll repeat, chelate formation increases the stability of a given compound or a drug. Example is ascorbic acid will undergo oxidative degradation in fruit juices. So what do? We go for addition of a chelating agent such as EDTA. So in the fruit juices and all, there will be certain ions such as iron, copper, etc. That is wrong. There will be some metal ions which are present, such as iron and copper, which will accelerate or which will enhance the degradation of this ascorbic acid. So now what this EDTA will do? EDTA will club or coordinate or interact with these metal ions, leading to the formation of chelates, and because of which ascorbic acid degradation is now prevented. That is, its degradation, which was accelerated due to these metal ions, now these metal ions are only entrapped, or it has formed a cyclic complex with EDTA. Therefore, the metal ions are no more available to accelerate the degradation of ascorbic acid. And next point, that is purification of hard water. Hard water means definitely it consists of certain ions, that is especially calcium ions. So this EDTA is used to remove the calcium ions from hard water. Hard water will be containing calcium ions. If you want to purify this hard water, you have to remove these calcium ions, and we go for addition of EDTA, which will form complex with the calcium ions. In this condition, what happens is, during purification, what happens is the chelate will get precipitated, and easily the precipitated can be removed from the water. Thus, the water is purified. Hard water contains calcium ions. If you want to purify hard water, you have to remove these calcium ions. For this reason, we add EDTA, which is a chelating agent. EDTA will complex with calcium ion, leading to the formation of a chelate. Chelate means it's a cyclic complex. And here, this chelate can be easily precipitated. It gets easily precipitated, and thus it can be separated from water. Precipitate can be easily washed away or separated from water. Thus, we are left over with purified water. Okay, so that is another application. The third application of chelate type of complexes is analysis of drug. See, whenever you have to go for analysis of drug, here this chelate complex is useful. The assay of procainamide in injectable solution, it is mainly based on 1:1 chelate formation with cupric ion at the pH of 4 to 4.5. That is, this chelate is usually a colored complex. This chelate formation, that is a chelate which is formed between procainamide, which is an injectable solution, and its chelate formation with cupric ion, it is a colored complex, and it can be easily estimated or assayed colorimetrically. You can just write down the third application is analysis of drug. Example is assay of procainamide in injectable solution. This much you can write. Just one sentence. And another example, another application of chelate is anticoagulant. See here, the citrates, oxalate, EDTA are used as in vitro anticoagulants for blood. All these three, oxalate, citrates and EDTA, all these three are the sequestering agents, or maybe the chelates. And these chelates are used in vitro coagulants for blood. In vitro means these are the experiments or practicals, or maybe experiments which will be conducted outside the body in vitro. So whenever such experiments are being conducted or such studies are being conducted, the in vitro anticoagulants used for blood will be these EDTA, citrates, etc. Now these ligands have the tendency to bind the calcium and interfere with the thrombin formation. If you go back to your HAP, when you studied about the blood chapter, there you had studied about that flow chart, blood clotting steps. There, one of the factors required for blood clot formation or thrombin formation was calcium. Now, when I add EDTA, it will entrap the calcium with it, or when I add any chelating agent, it will form a complex with the calcium. And now calcium will no more be available for clotting. So that's the reason I tell that for in vitro anticoagulants for blood, these chelating agents are used. So calcium is not available for the clotting process. That's the reason EDTA can be used as an anticoagulant. Okay. So these are some of the applications of chelate types of complexes. Now, in the textbook you have studied, we are having four different types of metal ion complexes or metal complexes. We studied till now about, in today's class, we studied inorganic types, where we studied the example of hexamine, cobalt, trichloride. Next, we studied about chelates. Now, speaking about olefin types. In CVS, they have not given much about olefin types. So for olefin and aromatic type, we'll study from Manavalan. Now here in this textbook, you can see olefin complexes. They are formed by reacting olefins. Olefins are nothing but the unsaturated compounds or unsaturated bonds with the metal ions. Interaction of the unsaturated molecules or bonds or ions with the metal ions will lead to the formation of olefin complexes. And here the example is aqueous solutions of platinum or silver. That is, when you take silver in water, that is aqueous solutions of platinum. Platinum is a metal, silver is also metal. Aqueous solutions of platinum or silver, they absorb the olefins. Olefins, let me take for example this ethylene, absorb the olefins, forming the water soluble complex. And these complexes are used as catalyst. So olefin complexes means I am taking aqueous solutions of platinum or silver where they absorb the olefins, leading to the formation of water soluble complex. The complex is formed between the olefins and aqueous solutions of metals, leading to the formation of a complex where these complexes are used as catalysts. So just this example is sufficient for olefin complex. Next we are having aromatic type of complexes. Here, aromatic type of complexes, they are usually formed with aromatic bases and metal ions, as the name only indicates. See, since aromatic type comes under metal complexes, it means definitely there is a metal ion. And the metal ion is the substrate. What will be the ligand here? So here, the ligand will be the aromatic bases. So aromatic type complexes means it is the bonds or it is the complex which is formed with the metal ion and aromatic base. And here they may be of three types. As you can see, now they may be pi bond or sigma bond or sandwich complexes. Now for the first one, first example. Now aromatic bases such as benzene and toluene, they'll form the pi bond complexes with silver ions. That is the example they have given for pi bond complex. Bases such as benzene and toluene. Benzene and toluene are the ligands. It will form pi bond complex. You need a metal ion, and here metal ion is the silver ion. That's it. So silver ion is the substrate. Benzene or toluene will be the ligand, and the bond formed between them is the pi bond, leading to pi bond complexes. Okay. Next. Next one is for sigma bond. Now a carbon of aromatic ring, it forms a sigma bond complex with metal ion such as aluminium. Such a sigma bond complex you could have seen in this Friedel-Crafts reaction. Definitely you would have studied about Friedel-Crafts reaction in your organic chemistry. There in Friedel-Crafts reaction, aluminium, here just to give an example, carbon of the aromatic ring forming a sigma bond with metal ion such as aluminium. And such a sigma bond complex you would have seen in Friedel-Crafts reaction. So that is the second type of aromatic complex, sigma bond complex. Third one is the sandwich complexes. Here an example of sandwich complexes is ferrocene. As the name only indicates, ferro means definitely it is related to iron. Ferrocene is nothing but dicyclopentadienyl iron 2. Dicyclopentadienyl 5 dienyl molecules with iron too. So it is about iron, which is a substrate, and pentadienyl, which will be the ligand leading to the formation of dicyclopentadienyl iron 2 complex, which is an example for sandwich complex. And this is referred to as sandwich complex because two molecules, that is cyclopentadienyl, it sandwiches this iron 2. Okay, so this is all about aromatic type. So overall, in today's class, we studied about the metal ion formation complexes. Inorganic type, chelate type, olefin type, and aromatic type. Just this one all alone. That is, they may ask you define complexes and explain metal ion formation complexes for 10 marks. If they ask you for 10 marks, please explain everything that we studied in today's class. Sometimes only for 5 marks, they may ask you chelate. That time you have to write what are chelates, what are sequestering agents, their examples, and chlorophyll and hemoglobin are the two naturally occurring chelating agents. Then give them the example of EDTA, how it clubs with the copper, and write down 4 of its applications. That's what we studied about the stability, about purification, and also you studied about 2 more, that is assay of drugs or analysis of drugs. Okay, so with that you write down. And yeah, in application of chelate, even we studied about anticoagulant. So write down the applications along with all the introduction part for chelate for 5 marks. This only if it is asked for 5 marks. If it is asked for 10 marks, please write down whatever we studied in today's class. Okay, it's an important 10 mark question. Then, so with this, I come to the end of today's class, that is compensation class 2. See you tomorrow morning. We'll start with engineering. We'll continue with engineering, where there will continue with size separation chapter. Okay. Any doubts here? Any doubts? Anything to ask? If no doubts, then wait. First, let me save your recording. Yeah. Follow then. Now I'll move. No doubts. Thank you, Suresh. Shall I find that?